Praise the Lord, Yahshua the Messiah, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Welcome back to the dinner table. As you know, the Lord said in Revelation that He stands at the door of our heart and He knocks. And if we would let Him in, He would come and have dinner with us. And of course, we want to taste and see that the Lord is good. Amen. So, that being said, got your plate. And we're going to get right into it. Hallelujah. As you know, we never come to the dinner table without washing our hands. So let's repent together. Say this with me. Lord Jesus Christ, forgive me for my sins. Wash me in your holy blood. Sprinkle your blood upon me. Mind, body, soul, spirit. Renew the spirit of my mind. And give me the mind that was in Christ Jesus. Bind up anything that would distract me. And allow me to receive this word. And walk therein. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. So, with that being said, we got, Lord willing, we got some words that we're going to be doing back to back this week. So stay tuned. You got plenty of food to eat. All glory to Jesus Christ, the chef of chefs. Can I get an amen? We're not really going to talk about too many announcements. One important one, though, for all of you that are partners, that are committed to being a part of this fight, that not only pray for us and tell people about the ministry, but you've committed to helping us financially. You are the Peter, James, and Johns. You are the ones that, you know, Jesus did not treat everybody the same, and He didn't even treat the 12 disciples the same. In fact, Peter, James, and John, He would take privately off and show them deeper things. And the other day, although there's been a lot going on, we would have had more videos out, but we had to do some traveling. God had sent us on a mission. And the Lord spoke to me. He said, "Did I not tell you, don't give jewels to the swine and the dogs? They trample them in the mud." And, you know, when I first heard Him say that to me, I was kind of like trying to figure out, you know, what He was talking about. And then He showed me. So there are certain teachings that we do. We are not going to put on YouTube. We're going to have it on our website. And it's going to be for partners only. Those that are partners, those that show their love not only with their mouth, but in their deeds and in their actions. They're actually praying for us. They're actually getting involved with our conference Bible studies. When we travel to their cities, they're being a part of the conferences. They're supporting financially and they're spreading the messages on their social media sites and things like that. You guys will be emailed or called with a personal passcode that you enter into our website, and you'll be able to log in and get certain messages that are not meant for everybody, especially the ones on spiritual warfare. We don't want our enemies knowing everything that we do. We know that there's quite a few people that watch our videos who hate us and hate Christ, but yet they watch our videos to spy on us, to see what we do, how we teach, and what our warfare tactics are, and we're not going to do it. So if you're a partner, you'll be getting a phone call or an email. We got to meet up with the web guys and have them integrated into the website, which will be coming real soon, Lord willing. And if you're not a partner, what are you doing? Let's get in this fight together. Make your commitment. You need this. It's healthy in your life to commit to the ministry that loves the Lord. We are here to bring the gospel of Jesus Christ and stand against the darkness. Why would you not support? But anyways, we love y'all. Let's go. So we got quite a few words coming. And this one right here is heavy. Okay, so we're going to get straight into it. I want you to get a pen and a paper. I want you to write this down. The dream world, the spirit of slumber, Incubus and Succubus. Write that down. The dream world. You could put that. That's enough. Because we're going to try to cover everything within like an hour. And Lord, guide me. Lord Jesus, I trust you to speak and preach through me. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ. So, I believe why I have another sermon that Lord willing will be uploading later on in the week. But God wanted me to do this first. Here's the thing. We're going to start off with the reading of the word as, of course, as usual. There's a prophecy that in the book of Acts, Peter was speaking that was coming to pass. And this is in the book of Joel. And before we get there, you have to know that in these last days, the enemy is trying very hard to hinder your gifts. A lot of you have the gifts of dreams and visions. A lot of you. But I'm getting too deep into it because you know why I'm smiling is because this sermon is a victorious sermon. It's a sermon that the Lord Jesus Christ has chefed up in the kitchen that has the nutrients and the minerals and the vitamins to fight off the attack of the enemy. I like that. That's good. That's good. Jesus. So what we're going to do, we're going to go to Acts and then we're going to go to where he's referring it. So go to Acts chapter 2. Follow me now. Amen. Acts chapter 2. You should have a pen. You should have a notepad. You should have your own Bible. Amen. Hallelujah. So, follow me as I follow Christ. The book of Acts chapter 2. Some of y'all are like, brother, I'm there. Alright, so, he says here in Jesus' name, as Peter was talking in verse 15, for these are not drunken as you suppose, seeing it is but the third hour of the day. But this is that which was spoken of by the prophet Joel. And it came to pass, and it shall come to pass in the last days, says God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens will I pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show wonders in heaven above, and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapors of smoke, and the sun shall be turned into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible day of the Lord. Wow. Now, of course, he's referring, and what I find interesting, I'm already excited. This is so good. And, you know, I've never heard preachers talk about this subject, and I believe this is a open door that the devil has been using his agents to really war against us, and nobody shuts the door. It's like, you know, having a whole bunch of mosquitoes in the house and not realizing there's an open door with no screen. You have to shut the door, kill the mosquitoes within, and you'll be good, right? So I just thank God that he was putting this on me and Lioness. We were fellowshipping about this, and we're talking about dreams. Because we have the gift of dreams. Both my wife and I have a lot of dreams. and as you grow in the Lord, you'll know what's from him and what's just a regular dream. And we're going to get into that in a minute. And I take this very, this is real. You know what I'm saying? Because I've not only seen it in my own life, dreams that have come to pass, things I've been able to warn people, but I've seen it through my wife, Lioness. She'll have a dream and to the T, it will come to pass. That is a gift that is given through Christ, and it's all glory to the Holy Ghost. So anyways, what I find interesting is Peter, here you are, Peter, in the second chapter of the book of Acts, talking about the prophecy, which is in the second chapter of the book of Joel. So let's go there. Now I know all my Puerto Ricans and my Dominicans is like, that's right, bro. It's Joel. It's Joel. You know what I mean? I got y'all, man. Joel. You know what I mean? Let's go. We at Joel. Come on. Where you at, Joe? See, that's the problem with Joel, man. He be trying to act all... Okay, I found him. Joel be on the run sometimes, you know what I mean? Trying to hide from my fingertips. So, Joel chapter 2, verse 28. It says, "And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions," and so on and so on. But here's the amazing thing. Peter wasn't well learned of the scriptures. He was a hood brother. He was a fisherman. You know what I'm saying? He's a rough cat. You know what I'm saying? So this was when the Holy Ghost filled in him. You will receive revelation, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding that you've never had. That's the power of receiving, the Bible says, the same mind that was in Christ Jesus. That's phenomenal. So now, here's what I've realized. Okay? This is a prophecy. Now, 2 days ago, or 2,000 years ago, because remember, the Bible says a day with the Lord is as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is as 1 day, right? So, 2 days ago, or 2,000 years ago, after Jesus Christ sent the Holy Ghost, in essence, God Almighty came to live in, as the Spirit of Christ in man, right? Women and children, whomever repents and believes, right? And this power manifested where the prophecy was fulfilled that we will dream dreams, have visions, and prophesy. How much more do you think it shall be now in the literal last hour of the last days? See, we're no longer in the last day. We're in the last hour of the last day. It's 12 o'clock. It's midnight. It's a wrap. The Lord is, and let me say this, you're picking the wrong time to be acting foolish right now. You're picking the wrong time to be backsliding. You're picking the wrong time to be halfway with the Lord. It is a very fearful thing to fall in the hands of the living God. Live right. I'm telling you, do the best you can for God now. I'm telling you, he's coming back, and you do not want to be living wrong when he cracks the sky or he calls you home. That's all I'm going to say. Now listen, we're in the last hour. The Bible says the latter house shall be greater than the former. So how much more should we be having dreams and visions and prophesying? Let me tell you something. I believe Satan knows this prophecy is manifested in the last hour, greater than it even was in the book of Acts. And what he's doing now is he is waging chemical warfare through the foods, through the drinks, and through medication. You know, Revelation says, by sorcery were all nations deceived, right? Have you ever, you know, seen how many people will say when they take certain medications, or even people that have trouble sleeping and they'll get a medication to help them sleep? That's terrible. Listen, stop. You do not need medication to go to sleep. You are messing with so much. You're messing with your brain. God will give you rest. And we're going to get into scriptures about that. I'm telling you, this is an amazing study. It's a breakthrough. And I'm so grateful and I'm honored to serve you right now at the dinner table and simply bring you the food that Jesus cooks. Amen. So, I believe that the devil is trying to distort our dreams. You ever, like, have memory issues where you can't remember your dreams? Like, you wake up, like, 1 minute you remembered it, but 3 seconds later after you wake up, there's no memory of your dream. And sometimes you'll know that God was trying to tell you something in a dream. Well, how many medications you see where it says it causes night terrors, nightmares, fear? How many of you are fearful at night? You hear weird sounds in your house. Well, we're going to get rid of all that fear right now in this sermon with prayer by the power of the Holy Ghost, with us in agreement. Y'all and us, hallelujah, you and I, we are going to come into an agreement where two or more are gathered in the name of Yeshua Christ. He is in the midst. And we're going to break these things. Amen. And you're going to not only sleep well, no more being afraid. And if you have the gift of dreams, now, some of y'all don't have the gift of dreams. In fact, some of you, it's going to get deep now, some of you inherited demons that mimic the fruit of the Holy Ghost. Some of you dream. Some of you can even, you have clairvoyant spirits and things like this. But when you give your life to Jesus Christ, you're supposed to renounce all generational curses, renounce all satanic powers that could operate through you and was passed down through generations. That way, you're not operating under the power of darkness thinking you're a dreamer, but you're operating under the power of the Holy Ghost, dreaming righteously when God warns you about something in a dream. Huh? Like Joseph. Look at Daniel. Look at these men and women of God who were given the power to dream. And what's so fast? Oh, this is so good. This is so good. Now, we're kind of going to go all over the place, but I promise it's going to work. Remember, those that are born again are like the wind. Wind goes all over the place. But listen, the dream world is an untouched topic. The church doesn't want to talk about it. But I believe the dream world is another dimension where God, ooh, this is so good. Excuse me, God has access to talk to you, to reach you, and to put a message or instructions into you. You know what? Go to Job. Let me show you something real quick. This is going to be an answered prayer for some of y'all. And I know some of y'all at the edge of your seat because you've never, you know, these are the teachings. And I'm so grateful the way God has been leading us. Wait till y'all see the other sermons that are coming, Lord willing. I'll tell you, if you just spend time with Jesus, if you truly love him, he will give you such word of wisdom and knowledge in the scriptures. He will teach you things and you're just going to be like, man. So we got a lot of amazing topics we're going to be talking about, Lord willing. Things you've never heard before or not in this way. And like I said, I thank God the way Jesus cooks in the ghetto gospel kitchen. Can I get an amen? So right now we're going to be at Job chapter 33. We got to be quick now. I would love to get this done within an hour. Hour and 15 minutes would be nice. Because some of y'all, you got that fast food mind. You know what I mean? Trying to eat a burger and drive. So I got to feed you quick. So it says in Job chapter 33, starting at 14, for God speaketh once, yes, twice, yet man perceives not. Pay attention. In a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls upon men, and slumberings upon the bed, then he opens the ears of men and seals their instruction, that he may withdraw man from his purpose and hide pride from man. You see that? You see that? God will try to tell you something in the natural realm. Won't listen. Try to tell you again. So God has to go through another dimension, right? But the problem is the devil knows about this dimension as well. You see? Now, I want you to look at it like this, right? Picture like a house. You got the front door. You got the back door, and you usually have a third door, whether it leads out through the side of the house where the garage is or a sliding door somewhere. But a normal actual house usually has three doors. Picture the front door as the physical realm we're in, this dimension right here, right? picture the back door as the spiritual dimension, right? This is the spiritual realm. Well, remember when the prophet prayed and said, Lord, show my servant, open up his mind in the spirit. And immediately the servant seen the mighty angels of war coming down to fight the prophet's enemies, right? That's a spiritual dimension, but yet it's like running parallel with this physical dimension. That's bananas. You know, a lot of these shows and stuff that the world is coming out with now, what's this one here, Stranger Things, which, I mean, if you had a dollar for every time they say blasphemous words and use the name of the Lord in vain, I mean, you could buy a new car, you know what I'm saying? But a lot of these movies and shows, they talk about the upside down world and things like that. They're corrupting and twisting it, but there's some truth in a sense, but not, you got to look at it from a biblical view, right? So what about the third door, though? This is the dream realm. It's the dream realm, I'm telling you. And you see, God has put that gift on a lot of us, where he wants to communicate with us in dreams. But there's certain things that we're doing. Some of us have been put on medication. And I believe a lot of children have the gifts. God is putting it into the young children. But the parents are not in tune. And they think their children are weird or crazy, or are talking and seeing things. And the teachers are telling them, oh, then you need medication for your son or daughter. And a lot of the schools will try to convince parents to put their children on medication because the boys are too hyper. I mean, a boy's a boy. You know what I'm saying? And they want children on medication to numb them and stop them from being able to see into the spirit realm and even in their dream realm. Ah, come on, this is so good. A lot of y'all, if you're on medication, you better start seeking the Holy Ghost, because that medication is sorcery. Now, some of y'all are like, brother, but if I don't take this medication, I'll die. I'm not saying immediately just stop. It depends on what it is and who you are. Everybody has a different circumstance. Some people have to wean off. Some people just got to stop, period. That's between you and Jesus Christ. You need to pray to him and say, Lord, they've told me I have bipolar my whole life. Don't you know your body will grow to feed off of that sorcery chemical in the pill? And it does something to the mind. Anyways, I don't want to get into that. It's a whole nother study. We got to stick to this. So now, here we are, and again, a lot of y'all have the gift, but you know, there's always that one Christian who always has a dream. You know the one I'm talking about. I had a dream, and some people will use this as witchcraft to get a gain over you or to get you to do something. Be very careful for that man or woman. They are operating out of witchcraft. They're usually the ones that always say, the Lord told me this, and the Lord said for you to do this, and the Lord, the Lord, the Lord, the Lord. Everything is the Lord. Prophets say, thus says the Lord. But we don't say it after every sentence. Okay, you got to watch for those people. Okay, and you have to watch for the ones who always have dreams, and it just seems the dreams benefit them. I had a dream. You're supposed to leave your husband. 3 months later, she's with him. You know what I'm saying? So be careful. But for a lot of y'all, this is a way God has been wanting to speak to you. But because of the foods that we're eating, we're not taking care of our bodies. The drinks, the fructose, corn syrups, the sodas, all of this, it is clogging your mind and your intellect, and it's messing with you. I'm telling you, the devil is using chemical warfare to attack the gifts of God from operating in you. Okay, look at it like this. Lord, help me. Help me. Perfect. Let's say you have a cable wire, right? The cable is crystal clean cable. It goes right into the cable box, right? But the wire from the box that goes into the TV gets chewed on by the dog when you're not home. And the wire is half off. So now the channels are, you're wondering what's wrong with your TV. Like the channels are coming in distorted. They go in and out. It loses its signal. The 4K ain't working right. Think about it like this. This is what the enemy is trying to do with a lot of y'all gifts of dreams and visions and prophecy. We have to be in prayer now, y'all. We have to live a life of reading our word and fasting and asking God to renew the spirit of our mind every single day, getting the same mind that was in Christ Jesus. And I'm telling you, you're going to start to see your dreams work. And God is going to speak to you. He's going to give you warnings in dreams. Oh, I'm telling you, I could testify of times lioness would just have a dream. And like a week later, it will come to pass to the detail. You know, and I want to be fair. And another, maybe we do a part two of these. She could tell you some of her dreams. That's one gift that's in her strong. And let me tell you something. It's because of her obedience to Christ. She loves the Lord and she wants to serve him and serve her husband and children and live for him. Ladies, I'm telling you, you have a gift. A lot of y'all sisters, God wants to use you. Remember what he said to Deborah, awake, awake, Deborah, awake. There's something about, you know, let me not go there right now. I'll give you a quick testimony of mine. God warned me in a dream about a murder. And I was able to stop a brother from going to jail for life in jail. This was years ago. And I had a dream that my barber's cousin was murdered. And that I seen him going to retaliate and kill the people that killed his cousin. And I warned him. And about 3 days later, his cousin was murdered. They found him dead on the scene. He had a shoddy. And in the dream, I seen a shoddy. And on his way, he had the gun and he was looking. He remembered the dream I warned him in the barbershop. And instead of going down this certain area where he knew the people that had beef with his cousin were, he turned and went to the memorial site where the candles were, and you know what I mean, on the corner of the street. And he just sat there looking at the place where his cousin was killed. And could you imagine a local congregation, a pastor in some congregation, they came to pray for the neighborhood and show respect to the person who died. And he ended up praying with them instead. You see how powerful that is? God came through me, through a dream, to warn me to touch somebody who's not in tune with God, to warn him, and that seed that I put in him about the warning activated at the right time to keep him from killing somebody who probably didn't even kill his cousin in the first place. That's one of tons that God has done for me and Lioness, and he can do it for you. So let's get into it now. We got a lot of things to talk about, and like I said, we got to be timely with it, right? So one thing I want to talk about is dreamed a dream. When you see that in the Bible where it says he dreamed a dream, this is where God comes into a dream to warn you, or he'll send an angel. Do you know an angel can come into your dream? So I'll give you a couple of examples real quick, and Genesis got a ton of them, so I don't have to go through all of them. But in Genesis chapter 20 verse 3. Write that one down. I'm not going to read that one, but I'm going to read Genesis chapter 28 verse 11 going down. It said, he lighted upon a certain place and tarried there all night because the sun was gone down. And he took of the stones of that place and put them for his pillows and lay down in that place to sleep. And he dreamed, and behold, a ladder set upon the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven. And behold, angels of God ascending and descending. Now, this is where Jacob fled from Esau. And he put his head on the rock. And he had a dream. And he seen a literal vision of the window, the gates of heaven opened up, and the angels ascending and descending on this place named Bethel. Notice his head was on the rock. The rock represents Christ. The rock represents Christ. Remember, the Bible says that rock was Christ. So when you sleep, sleep on Christ. Have him on your mind. This is why you should make a habit of reading your word before bed. Now, we're going to get into that later, and may God remind me. Some of y'all are distorting your dreams because you're watching TV up until you go to bed, or you eat late at night. These things have an effect on your dreams. It's not God's end. It's like the cable wire going into the cable box is perfectly fine. It's the other wire going into the TV or into your mind that's been corrupted. What could God do about that besides hope that you snap out of it, right? So, look at it like this. At least 2 to 3 hours before you go to bed, stop technology. Don't eat. You know what I mean? Because a lot of y'all are on your iPhones. And you wonder why you can't sleep. You're staring at a bright light. You know what you do when your room is pitch black and you got your iPhone? You say, just take it and turn it to the wall. Watch how bright that light actually really is that you're staring at. And imagine what it does to the mind. You know what? Let's just stick to the script here. So this is Jacob having a dream. So his mind was on the rock, which represents Christ. So the number one thing to start activating your dreams is read the word of God. Meditate on Christ at least while you're in bed. However long usually we're on the phone in bed, you know, on Facebook or whatever you do for a half hour, 45 minutes, even an hour. Some of y'all can't sleep at night. But God is going to help you. Put the phone down. You want it all day anyways. Get your Bible and read. Put your mind on the rock. Corinthians says what? That rock was Christ. That's real good. So anyways, again, let's go now to Genesis 41. There's a lot of them. I'm not going to go to all of them, okay? Genesis 41. I'm just trying to prove a point. And look, this study is bananas. Like, this could be a 4-hour teaching. So we might have to do a part two. This is enough to get you right. I'm more interested in the prayers that I'm going to teach you by the grace of God and through Christ. I'm going to teach you certain prayers. They're going to break certain curses, push away demons of the night or the spirits of slumber, and activate the gifts in you of dreams and visions if God has it in you. Amen. This is beautiful. So now Genesis chapter 41. Look at what it says in verse 15. And the Pharaoh said unto Joseph, I have dreamed a dream, and there is none that can interpret. Now, I'm not going to get into the whole dream Pharaoh had. That's not where we're going with this tonight. Same thing with Daniel. I have dreamed a dream. Actually, if you go to Genesis 40, it says here, verse 8, and they said unto him, we have dreamed a dream, and there is no interpreter of it. So listen, maybe some of y'all, it's not that you get dreams, but some of you have the gift of interpretation. Now, I happen to have that gift. But let me explain something to you. It's not a boastful thing if I say to you that I not only do I dream, but I can also give the interpretation. The reason why nobody can boast about that is because I can't interpret unless God allows me to. There'll be some people that'll contact us that know that we interpret dreams. And through Christ, of course, sometimes I can't interpret. If God don't open up that door, if God don't allow me to see the interpretation, I'm not going to interpret it. But I believe God does it on purpose. Sometimes God won't allow you to heal through his name, even if you healed in the past, even if you've done miracles in the past through the name of Jesus Christ. God sometimes will not let it come to pass. Either A, he just simply don't want to, he has another plan in mind, or B, he wants you to know it's him in charge and not you. Because some of us would get too cocky. We'll have a 1-800 interpret dreams. Call me anytime. I'm the interpreter. It don't work that way. God has to allow it for it to work, right? So some of you have the gift of interpretation, where when you hear a dream from somebody, you can see the message. That's important. It's like when someone speaks in tongues, somebody else has to be the interpreter of the tongues, you see? Anyway, so I've noticed a pattern here, right? The dream. And the best way to put this is when God comes into your dream, and it's almost like a dream within a dream, where the enemy cannot get involved with. He can't understand it. God, wow, this is so deep. It's like a thought within a thought. You know what I'm saying? Like it's kind of hard to explain, actually. But this is where God comes to warn you about something, or tell you about something, or put instructions into you. Lioness has literally received songs. One of her songs, an amazing song, she woke up with the song. Jesus actually gave it to her in her sleep. And the same thing with me. I've received songs through my sleep. I've received sermons in my dream, where in the dream, I'm preaching a sermon about a certain topic, and I wake up. And for a lot of y'all that have that gift, your problem is, A, you're not sleeping with a notebook by your bed. Wake up, write your dreams down. Don't worry, God will let you know which ones to discard that weren't from him. You know, some of y'all call me up, Brother Works, man, I had a dream. Oh, it was crazy, man. This building blew up, and you know what I'm saying? People were running all over the place on fire. I'm like, well, bro, what was you watching on TV last night? Some Netflix movie called London Has Fallen. I see why you had the dream, bro. See, the tell-eye vision, this is good. You know when you was younger, you would take that rock and you would throw it across the lake, and eventually it would hit the water and sink down deep into the bottom of the lake. What the tell-eye vision does, or the cable, what TV does, and even iPhone watching things, is a lot of that will go into your mind, skip across your mind like the lake, and that subliminal message will sink down into the subconscious, or the bottom of the lake of your mind, and the enemy will stir it up in your sleep, where you're having weird dreams. But a lot of times it's what you're watching. Oh, this is so good. So anyways, I wanted to basically talk about the dream, a dream, right? Because that's what it means in the Hebrew. It's where God steps in, right? And visits us in our dream realm. Now, Daniel chapter 2, that's another one. Daniel had the gift of dreams and the interpretation. Joseph, right? You know the story of Joseph. He had dreams. Remember, he said he seen the sun and the moon and the stars bow to him, but it was actually, it was a real dream. The interpretation was what? His brothers bowing to him, even his very father bowing to him. Not that doesn't mean worshiping Joseph. It means that they would come to him one day in desperate need of salvation. Because remember, God used Joseph to interpret the Pharaoh's dream to save Israel, to save Egypt, to save everybody. Man. So, we got a lot to get into. Okay. How do I want to do this? So, just to recap. So this third doorway, right? We got the physical dimension. We got the spiritual realm, right? The spiritual dimension. And then we got the dream realm, or the dream world. Now, I want to show you something. Go to Matthew. Hallelujah. You enjoying this meal? This is amazing. Once again, the Lord never fails. Matthew chapter 1, I want to show you something, verse 20. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not. Take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus, Yahshua. For he shall save his people from their sins. You see that? Wow. Then I got to thinking, if an angel of the Lord can visit you in your dreams, can fallen angels? Can demons? And we're going to get into that. We're going to talk about certain demons like incubus, succubus, the old hag, the mare, or the nightmare, night terrors. And a lot of y'all suffered from that for many years, and some of y'all still suffer from it. Some of y'all children, like clockwork, every night around the same time. So your problem is you're not paying attention to the time y'all children come in scared and want to lay in bed with you. I thank God. See, we know how to pray in this home. Our sons sleep good. Amen. Because Jesus Christ is the protector of this home, and angels set at watch in the four corners of this house. And I'm going to show you a prayer that you will do. So, one second. So if an angel of the Lord can visit us in our sleep, then most certainly demons and fallen angels can creep in if we're not living right. If there's sin in the camp, if we're doing things that we ought not, if we're living lukewarm, right? Because the more righteous you live, and I told y'all I got a sermon coming this week, Lord willing, about the whole once saved, always saved, or the eternal security, right? And we're gonna really dissect and break open the scriptures on that. But you have to realize that you can't just repent and get washed in the blood and live any way you want to. You have to live righteous and holy. Like Lioness said the other day, without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. So, when you're not living right, the walls of protection start to be brittle and break down. And eventually the enemy can creep in. He might not be able to destroy you completely, God forbid, but a lot of damage can take place. A lot of things can be corrupted. A lot of fruit could be torn out that was supposed to bear and bring glory to the name of Jesus in your life. So live righteous and holy. After all, doesn't the Lord deserve it? Amen. So anyways, we got a lot to get into. We're going to talk about a couple of things now. One is should I go there now, Lord? All right, go to Psalms 91 with me. Come on, take a walk. Psalms 91. I'm going to show you something. You know what? Sorry, y'all. I don't feel led to do that one yet. We got to save that one because I'm trying to do it in this certain order, because Psalms 91 is going to be part of the prayer that we do at the end of the sermon, okay? So, in the name of Jesus Christ, let's talk a little more about this whole sleep thing. You notice that in the book of Acts, chapter 20, now you write it down, it's verse 9-ish. Paul was preaching, and it was about 12 at night, and there was a young brother named Eutychus. Now, Eutychus fell asleep, and he fell out of the window. Imagine that. Whew. I mean, that's an embarrassing way to go to heaven, huh? You know what I'm saying? Because, I mean, I'm not saying, the Bible don't say if the brother was lost or not. Who knows? He might have been saved, but just, like, you know what I mean? Just not living a little fleshy lately or something. You know, who knows? He just got attacked with a demon of slumber, and we're going to talk about that in a minute. But he falls out the window, bam, dies. Right? And Paul has to run down and raise him back up from the dead. Man. What happened, though? I believe. Now, listen carefully. I can't take this. I can't handle this. It's so good. This is so good. I believe the devil operates in this dimension and he bleeds into this realm. What do I mean by that? He sent a demon from the dream world. You see, there's demons that operate in the spirit world. It's so deep, Lord. There's demons that operate in this world, right? This is the manifestation of demons. They can manifest in this realm, but they operate in the spiritual realm. But there's also demons that operate in the dream realm. And when they can bleed through, they can cause people to be tired. Oh, it's so good. You ever notice? You could be chilling, watching TV for hours. You won't yawn once. But the minute you go to read your Bible, what happens?
Chapter 1, verse 1.
You know what I'm saying? Come on, keep it real. That's happened to me in the past. I'm telling you. And if you try to fight your yawn, you ever fight your yawn? Your jaw be all shaking. You're like, you trying to hold your yawn. I tell you, there's a spirit involved. You see? And the proof is, you can test it out. Do something fleshy. Nah, I'm not saying worldly and sinful. But, you know what I mean? Watch a little TV show that's not ungodly. Right? Or a movie or something. Watch how many times you yawn. Bet you none. Pay attention, though, when you go to pray. You ever notice you feel tired a lot? You feel weak and tired? I bet you there's a spirit of slumber that's been sent against you to keep you tired all the time. The dream realm. The devil is operating in the dream realm to keep you nodding off and sluggish and tired. Remember, Jesus talked about the five foolish virgins. That word foolish means sluggish, lazy and tired and drowsy. So I believe there was a demon that creeped in and started to attack Eutychus in the mind. That's why when you start feeling that drowsy, you have to combat it. You have to fight it. Go wash your face with cold water. Command that demon from the dream realm to leave and go back to the sender in Jesus' name. Shake it off like Paul did the viper into the fire. But you got to realize, though, the sleep realm is no joke. Sometimes dreams can overtake a person to the point where they just can't handle it. Look at the disciples when Jesus went to go pray. Oh, come on. Y'all got me preaching now. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. What did he say in Matthew? You write it down. I'll kind of paraphrase it and I'll put it on the screen. What did Jesus say in Matthew? He said, pray. This is an important time for me. Pray. What did the disciples do? They fell asleep. You think that's natural? You think that's normal? They walking with Jesus for 3 years. Really close now. Not only he's our Lord, but that's our friend. You know what I'm saying? There was a bond that was developed between the disciples and Jesus. Well, not Judas, but even Judas, though, Jesus still called him friend, and God don't lie. But my point is this, Judas hung himself. He was of the wicked one. But my point is this, what do you think happened? The enemy came through the dimension of dream world and started to make them drowsy and tired to stop their prayer. A lot of y'all, you go to pray and you get tired all the time. You better know where your enemy's coming from. So you didn't know about that third door, that other dimension. You just think spiritual and physical. No, there's a dream dimension too. Wow. So anyways, the disciples fell asleep. They became weak. Well, go to Romans. I'm going to show y'all something. Check this out. This is Romans, I want to say 11. Let's go here. Yep, Romans 11, verse 8. 7 going down. What then? Israel has not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election hath obtained it. and the rest were blinded, according as it is written, God hath given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see and ears they should not hear. Unto this day, there is a spirit of slumber that it can be sent and used by the enemy to keep you drowsy and weak all the time, tired all the time. Some of y'all nap all day. It's ungodly. It's unnatural. Now, we could get into Proverbs. I'm going to give you three Proverbs I want you to read on your own time. I'm not going to do it right now. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6 through 9. Proverbs chapter 20, verse 13. Read the whole thing so you get a bigger overview of it. And Proverbs chapter 24, around verse 33-ish. These talk about love not sleep, lest you fall into poverty. Do not be a sluggish sleeper. Wake up, arise, says the Lord. See, the problem with some of y'all is you sleep so much. That's why you're falling into poverty. And that don't just mean poverty financially. It means poverty in wisdom, poverty in joy, poverty in the knowledge of Christ. Why are you sleeping so much? This is ungodly. So anyway, you have to immediately declare war on this. You don't have time. You have to be sober, up, vigilant. You have to be looking, getting ready for the return of the Lord. Amen. So now, we're talking about this. We went over, don't worry, I haven't forgot about Psalms 91. We talked about Matthew 26, where they're sleeping in the garden, right? You can write that down. Now, don't mind me. I'm just thinking, because this is a lot. This is huge. You know what I'm saying? So the other realm, there's like three different places I want to go with this, right? So one is, I want us now to kind of veer off into what happens with people that get attacked by the demons. Then I want to talk about scriptures where God tells us to wake up, stay awake. Then I want us to talk about scriptures where God says he will give us rest and for us, not to be afraid. Because a lot of y'all get afraid at night. And it's because you know you hear things. And you ain't crazy. You like, why do I hear like movement in the night? It's probably an old hag spirit. There are certain demons that are operating with the dream realm, but also of the night. They come out in the night, right? Remember, Jesus said, we are of the light. We do not operate in the night. But we sleep and rise up early. Hallelujah. So, how many of y'all... Oh, no, I can't do that. I got to show y'all a video real quick. This is going to blow your mind. So, the devil has his servants, satanic, priests, witches, magicians, warlocks from all over the world that know about the dream realm. And they know, listen, I'm going to play a video real quick on the screen. And it's an Asiatic magician, a sorcerer, a warlock, a witch from Asia. And he figured out how to tap in to the dream realm and actually put a spirit of slumber on animals or people. Now, I'm going to show you where I'm going with this. In this video I'm about to play for y'all, he starts going like this, right? But he's emanating a certain power. It's real. Some of y'all might not believe it, but I'm telling you, it's real. Okay? And you're going to see animals just dropping and going to sleep. Dropping and going to sleep. Let me play the video. But before I play the video, I'll just play the video. And then we'll talk as soon as I'm done. All right? All right. Bless.
I've come to a Californian ranch with Kinsawa Sensei, who claims he can put any animal into a trance.
Right? But this is real. The reason why I wanted to play that video is because imagine how many witches are tapping into this power and sending it your way? You wondering why you drowsy all the time? Why you always like weak and tired? You're dozing off during the day. You're taking cat naps, right? They call it, which we know what cat nap really means in witch language, right? And you're always taking naps, and you just this weird tiredness. You yawn all the time. How do you know you don't have someone praying against you, sending the spirit of slumber to you? Sending that curse your way. Think about what I'm saying. You have to learn not only to pray for protection, but you have to pray and fight against it. It's twofold. See, the problem with a lot of y'all believers is you only pray for a protection, but you don't swing back with your sword of the spirit. You don't strike back at the enemy. You have to not only ask God to protect you from the witchcraft of demons of slumber and from the nightmare and incubus and succubus, but you also have to say, I drop fire from heaven in Jesus' name on these evil ones. Obviously, we don't drop fire from heaven on human beings, but we can burn the fire on devils and demons. And you can actually disempower witches and warlocks. Listen to me carefully. The same way Paul turned around. Remember the girl that was following him around in the book of Acts saying, these men are servants of the Most High God who are telling us the way to be saved. He commanded that demon to come out of her, and she was no longer able to perform her powers of psychic powers, or what they would call the pythos or the python spirit, right? He took it out of her. Do you know that if you're walking right with the Lord and you're in the Holy Ghost, you can take powers from witches, strip them of their powers? That's called fighting back. Huh. I know that's beautiful. So, because God is trying to tap into the dream world. You remember in the book of Acts when Paul seen the vision in the night hour of the man saying, come, we need you. I think it was in Macedonia. He's like, we need your help. I'll put the scripture on the screen. That was God, but Paul was in tune with God. He was walking righteous. So Paul was able to see visions and dreams and get messages and warnings from God. Oh, Lord. Please help my brothers and sisters take this very, very, very intensely serious, because this is no joke. So, dream the dream, right? So, where we at? What am I talking about? So, So, basically, you know, the same way that warlock was able to use those powers and send that spirit of slumber on the animals. Are you telling me that's all they're doing it to? Nah. Ultimately, their main goal is to wear down the saints through as many ways as they can. Think of all the ways we're being attacked right now. You better be in the Holy Ghost, and you better be living right, for real. Amen. In Jesus' name. Now let's tap into certain things about the enemy. Okay, and then we're going to veer off into another topic about waking up, staying awake. And we're going to learn the prayers. So go to Psalms 91. Psalms 91. In Jesus' name. Check this out. So Psalms 91 says this. Now, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noise and pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flies by day. Now pause. The Psalms 91, if you're being attacked at night, you need to memorize this chapter, this Psalms. You need to read this at night with your children. Read this at night in your bed with your spouse. Declare this Psalms over your home. Walk around your house reading this chapter, because first off, you have to be in the secret place of the Most High and abiding under the shadow of the Almighty. This is where you are protected. There's a mystery about shadows. And even Peter and them, their shadows were healing people. How much greater does the shadow of Christ shield you? Huh? So notice it says, you shall not be afraid of the terror by night. This is that those demons that come in the night hour. They are in cahoots with the demons of the dream realm. Okay? And they work as a team. So these spirits of the night, right? The demons of the night. One of them is night terror. Now we're going to go through a couple of the main ones. I can't go through all of them. Okay? But we're going to go through a couple names. And I got them. I had some pictures I'm going to put on the screen of certain scripture, demons and fallen beings that you will learn to pray against. Now, some of you have heard the word nightmare, right? Mostly everybody has heard the word nightmare, but mare is the name of the demon. They just add the nightmare, right? But this is a demon that creeps in at night and tries to bring fear and terror among people. So we have to pray against nightmares, right? And again, I'll put these on the screen. And the one I wanted to show you, mare, okay? Mare is an evil spirit or goblin in Germanic or Slavic folklore that rides on people's chests while they sleep, bringing bad dreams or nightmares. A lot of times these demons have been depicted little small creatures. Demons can come in many different sizes and shapes. They're not always human size. Just like angels or fallen angels can be huge. I'm talking bigger than trees. Or just a ball of light that will go like this and then boop, disappear. I'm telling you, angels can transform. That's biblical. So now, the two main ones I want to talk about is incubus and succubus. Okay? And I'll put these on the screen real quick. I'm just going to do incubus, but you'll be able to, incubus and succubus are one and the same. It's just a male and female version. But okay, I got it right here. So incubus is a male form who, according to mythological legend traditions, lies upon sleeping women in order to engage in sexual activity with them. Listen, you remember in Jude? Oh, Lord, that's the Holy Ghost right there. I love the way the Lord is so faithful. He makes sure that scriptures are brought into light that are needful, right? Remember in Jude it says, verse 8, likewise also these filthy dreamers defile the flesh, despise dominion, and speak evil of dignities. This is bananas. A lot of y'all sisters that get attacked is because you despise dominion. You're not honoring God as a father. You probably don't honor your husband as the head of the house. You probably try to rule over him and have a Jezebel spirit. Or you don't honor men of God that come around. Now, you need to repent. Because this is talking about men too, but we're talking about incubus. I'm going to get to succubus in a minute, which is for men. A lot of you that what they call wet dreams, forget all that little harmless terminology. You were attacked by a demon in the night who came in female form to... Now listen, think of how crazy this is, right? Think of how crazy this is, where you're sleeping. And in the dream realm, there's a demon that merges between the dream realm and the physical realm and literally causes a man in bed to literally ejaculate in his underwear. You can't tell me there's no connection here, how the dream realm and the physical realm can merge. I'll never forget, years ago, I was, I don't know how old I was. I was in the Lord, and I had this dream. I went into this elevator, and I went high up into the sky, high up. See, one thing with us, we should never be ashamed of things that's happened to us, because a testimony strengthens other people. You know, and a lot of preachers try to sugarcoat their whole life like they've never gone through things. I ain't got time for all that. A lot of the brothers is pretenders. They're fake. A lot of them are going through the worst things, and they're dangerous to follow. But listen to this. I went in this high elevator, high up. I mean, past everything. It was like in the heavenly realm, not heaven where God is, but the outer space realm, right? Right at where the Earth's atmosphere starts to veer off into space. And the doors opened, and there was a balcony. And there was a sister. And, yeah, she was obviously not ugly. You know what I'm saying? And she was very well structured, really well formed. And the door shut behind me. And the balcony shrunk, and I came right up behind her as her back was facing me. And she turned and looked at me. She goes, "I can have you anytime." And she backed her booty. How do I say that? What's a biblical? What do y'all want me to do? I mean, butt, whatever word works for you, right? Her buns. She backed up onto my groin, and immediately I was like, oh, and I woke up and I got hit. I got hit by the succubus spirit, and I learned a lesson from that, okay? God had to teach me to pray for protection in my dream realm, to protect me from succubus. Some of y'all don't know, that's why you keep getting attacked as men. You keep getting attacked with wet dreams and weird dreams, and you see? And of course, as I grew and matured in the Word, I grew and matured in my walk with Christ, God shielded me. And later on in life, He showed me what that dream, why God would even allow that dream. You see, sometimes God will let the enemy swing on you so you don't get too comfortable. Remember, David fell when he was comfortable in a bed. Wow, I didn't even see that. Ooh. Lord, you are so good. Can't you see how symbolic it is that King David fell in a bed? It said he was in bed, chilling, watching Netflix. When men ought to be at war, David was on his bed in the night hour. And it says he seen Bathsheba, right? You see that, right? But you notice, though, that God will allow you to get swung at by the enemy so you keep on your guard. He don't want you to be sluggish and thinking everything is sweet all the time. My Bible says the enemy roars around as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour. So God allowed me to get that dream so that way as I grew in the Lord, I could get ready to fight that witch, that Jezebelian spirit, that seductress succubus spirit. No, you cannot have me whenever you want. Jesus is mine and I am His. Amen. That's how you have to be. You cancel certain dreams when you wake up. You do not accept those dreams in the name of Jesus Christ. Ladies, same thing with y'all. Some of y'all get seduced by the incubus spirit. He knows how to come. He may appear in physical realm. He's a really ugly looking gremlin demon. But in the spirit, in the dream realm, he could appear 6'1" with a six pack, the hair the way you like it, the eyes, he's got the voice you like, and you just, ooh, in your sleep, you wake up and look over to your husband like, oh, shoot, what just happened to me? So we're going to learn how to pray. Amen. We're going to learn that these demons ain't allowed in our houses. They're not allowed to enter in through the dimension of dreams. Huh? Come on. So incubus and succubus, you have to realize that the dream world is more powerful than people think. And it's something that is not talked about barely any time in the church ministries. So when you look at it, how many times God uses dreams to get a hold of us. I mean, even in Matthew 27:19, God warned the woman to warn Pilate. Remember that. She said, "Have nothing to do with that righteous man, for last night I suffered greatly in a dream because of him." And you see all through the scriptures, God will come through dreams to contact us and warn us through this dimension that's not even talked about a lot. And the same thing applies with the enemy, how they try to find doorways of sin to be able to have access to our dream world where they can plant seeds as well. And believe it, what they try to do is plant seeds in our dreams in hopes that it will manifest in the physical realm in our mind. If you're a husband or a wife, for example, have you ever had a dream of your spouse cheating on you? How did you feel when you woke up? Now, your spouse could be righteous and godly. He or she loves the Lord, and you've never had a thought of your spouse committing adultery, but you had to fight that seed out of your heart. In fact, you probably woke up and gave your spouse a strange look. This is the power that dreams can have. So we have to guard our hearts. We have to make sure we are living a life of prayer. And you do a good prayer before you go to bed. Don't just do some halfway now I lay me down to sleep prayer. Pray for real. In the name of Jesus Christ. And of course, I will show y'all some prayers at the end of the sermon. And I'm telling you, when you look at it, like for example, for leaders in the ministries, I know my wife and I, God has told us about people in the churches. You know, if somebody is hiding sin, for example, in the congregation, God will let us know through dreams. And we'll approach that person. And I know brothers and sisters that have been in this ministry for a long time, they've said jokingly, but at the same time, sincerely, sometimes they get like worried when we call them and say we have to talk about something. They're like, "Oh no, what did God tell them in a dream?" And I kid you not, we got people in this ministry that can testify to how God speaks to us in dreams. And you know, he is very faithful. You have to be aware of not only how God can come into dreams, and you want to make sure your mind is on Christ when you go to bed, but also because the enemy will strike in the night hour, not only with incubus and succubus, but also astral projection. Here you have witches and warlocks that will get into a trance, tap into the dream realm, and travel through the astral planes looking for your home to attack you. You have to also be aware of astral projection. These witches and warlocks have figured out how to utilize the dream dimension to benefit their satanic agendas. And I'll tell you a testimony one time, how there was a man, I was three-way talking with him and another brother, and he was just on the verge of giving his life to the Lord. And he said one of the things that convinced him was he used to astral project. And he said how he would lay down and get into a deep meditative state. And finally, he tapped into the dream realm where he would leave his body and travel through the astral plane. And one time he seen these demons, very demonic looking beings. They were rising up to try to grab at his feet, and he got afraid, and he just said the name Jesus. He didn't even say it with that much faith, but just at the utterance of the very holy name of Jesus Christ, he said the demon scattered and went back down under. And this is a man who didn't even really, he wasn't even on the verge yet. He just started to follow after the Lord. So y'all gotta realize this is a real war. And this is a dimension the enemy comes through that a lot of people don't know about. So you have to secure your spiritual door, your natural doors, and your dream doors. In the name of Jesus Christ. Sleep paralysis. Now, this is when some of y'all have been held down. We had a young sister, shout out to our beloved young prophetess Lila. She had a dream where she was being held down by a demon. And I say this for y'all that have children, for y'all young sisters out there, young brothers. Lila's young. And she was attacked in her bed. And the demon held her down. She seen the shadowy figure. And she just was like, in the name of Jesus. And it whoop, went running right down the hall and ran and disappeared. That is the power of the name of Jesus Christ, Yeshua the Messiah. You see? But she couldn't move. And a lot of y'all have been in sleep paralysis where you can't move. And I'm going to give you warning. Sometimes you can't even talk. But guess what? You can say the name of Jesus Christ within your inner man, and it'll still work. Call on the name of the Lord. Amen. Because when you call his name, he shows up, and the demons are terrified of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Oh, I love this word. Lord, I love you, Jesus. Can we just take a praise break? This is a word that is needed. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So, incubus, succubus, nightmare. Now, the old hag. This one, Brother Hurricane. I don't know his doctrine, but he got deep with it on his video. He talked about how, you know, he grew up around witchcraft and voodoo. And, you know, thank God he got saved. I think that's his name, Hurricane. I'll have to double check. I might be off. But he mentioned the old hag. And the hag, or the old hag, was a nightmare spirit. And basically, being with roots in the ancient Germanic superstitions and closely related to Scandinavian and different other cultures, an old hag sat on a sleeper's chest and sent nightmares to him or her. When the subject awoke, he or she would be unable to breathe or even move for a short period of time. And of course, I ain't going to get into the whole thing, these demons are like and what their favorite food is. We're not here to glorify them. Amen. We're here to expose and rebuke them in Jesus' name. But the old hag slithers around in a dark shadow in the night hour. And you have to pray against this spirit. Here's one that's really deep. Sudden infant death syndrome, SIDS. Now, this is directly linked to the Lilith demon, okay? Directly linked to the demons of the night. If you have a child, you need to come against the curse of SIDS, the sudden infant death syndrome. Now, I'm going to play a quick clip. Doctors still can't explain how babies just wake up dead, okay? And they don't know how this is happening, but we know that there are demons that creep in the night. And if somebody ain't living right, and they don't know how to apply the blood of Jesus on their children and on each other, that demons can do certain things. And unfortunately, sometimes people die. Children die. So you need to speak that prayer. And you need to learn this prayer that I'm going to teach y'all at the end of this sermon. I'm going to show you a quick clip of a movie. Now, when I show you these movies, don't go renting the movies. I'm showing this so you can see that even in Hollywood, they know the truth. But they distort it and cover it up with just movies. And you would never guess that this stuff is real. Check out this clip. You've seen it, right? Now, of course, it was just a movie, but that's a lot of truth in these movies. These demons will try to take the life of that child and suffocate that child. Remember, they can merge. You know that, because how are you able to have a wet dream, but yet it's just your sleep? There is something going on. There are physical beings that will come into the natural realm, but they can also come through the supernatural realm or bombard you in the dream realm. Imagine that, working as a team against you. You see that? Where they're putting the thoughts into your mind through the dream realm, and they're also attacking you physically in the spirit, in this natural realm. So we're going to learn to pray a prayer of protection around the children, that these demons are not allowed in the house. Amen. Now, you ever heard, and this is how you know so many people are asleep. The Bible talks about they're asleep even to this very hour. And you ever heard someone say, "I'm living the dream, dog, I'm living the dream"? Tell that person, well, it's time to wake up and find Christ. Because we're not supposed to be living a dream. Oh, I had a dream. Or, I want to, life is but a dream. No, 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 no. We're supposed to be awake. Amen. Matter of fact, Ephesians chapter 5, verse 14, you read it on your own time. It says, "Awake thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Jesus Christ shall give thee light." First thing God tells you to do is wake up. You see what I'm saying? Now, there's another one too, the curse of the night owl. This is a curse witches will do where you can't sleep at night. Where it's like insomnia. You're up, you can't go to bed. We're going to pray against that as well. Amen. The other thing too is, you know, there's a lot of truths. I know y'all remember Freddy Krueger, Nightmare on Elm Street. They would try to stay awake because he would come in through the dream dimension, the dream world, or the dream realm. You see? Think about it logically. Jesus can come into the natural realm, so can't the devil and his evil ones, right? That Jesus and his holy angels and the enemy and his evil beings, right? Jesus can operate in the spiritual realm with his holy angels, but the enemy also can operate in the spiritual realm. So why would it be different for the dream realm or the dream dimension or the dream world? Think about what I'm saying is logic. It makes perfect wisdom. So anyway, there's other demons I don't want to mention. I just wanted to mention the main ones, and we'll cover all of them with simply just praying against any one of them. Instead of naming 30 different demons that creep in the night hour, you ain't going to shoot. You'll be in bed an hour and a half later if you had to do a prayer like that, right? So I want to talk about scriptures about staying awake. Now, ladies, this is for y'all, okay? Proverbs 31 says you are to rise up early. Amen. Before your husband and children, try your best. I know some of y'all are such hard workers at home, and you do so much, it gets exhaustive sometimes. God will give you strength. Rise up, not only because you need that one-on-one time with the Lord. That's one of the main reasons. One of the main reasons is because you don't have, "Mommy, I need this," or "Honey, where's my tire?" You're not being interrupted. God wants alone time, and it shows God you're not loving sleep. Amen. But what did God say to Deborah? If you read Judges chapter 5, verse 12, he said, "Awake, Deborah, awake." Right? So, ladies, y'all that are in the Lord, or you serve the Lord, you have the fight of Deborah in you. Not to lead men as a pastor and try to usurp authority, but to encourage men for war. Amen. Encourage the brothers and your husband and everyone else. It's time for battle. Amen. You play a mighty role in the gospel, sisters. Hallelujah. So, Isaiah chapter 60, I thought it was pretty cool. I would mention verse 1. My mom used to say a lot of times to me when I was younger, "Rise and shine, honey, rise and shine." That's actually biblical. If you read Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1, God talks about rise and shine. Now, if you go to Revelation, hallelujah, Revelation chapter 3, check it out. Be watchful and strengthen the things which remain and are ready to die, for I have not found thy works perfect before God. Verse 3. Remember therefore how thou hast received and heard, and hold fast and repent. If therefore thou shalt not watch, I will come unto thee as a thief, and thou shalt not know what hour I come. That in the Greek is talking about stay awake, stay watchful, don't be sleeping. That's what he's saying there. This is huge. If you go to 1 Corinthians, let's go there. Come on. We got to be quick here. Like I said, there's so much to this. I can't cover everything in this little bit of time, but it's enough to expose you to the truth and protect you. Amen. And get you ready to see the gifts, dreams, and visions. All right, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 34. Awake to righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. I speak this to your shame. See, he's talking about wake up. Wake up. Go to 1 Thessalonians. Watch this. There's a lot of these. I'll just give you a few. I shouldn't need to give you 20 scriptures on God telling us to wake up. Amen. Y'all agree with me, right? 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 5 going down. You are all the children of light and of the children of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. For they that sleep, sleep in the night, and they that be drunken are drunk in the night. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet the hope of salvation. You see that? So basically he's saying, look, there's a lot of people that are awake, but they're asleep. That spirit of slumber is even got people sleepwalking. They're out there at work, they're doing their thing, but they're completely asleep in the spirit realm. Oh, I just caught that. Wow, I just caught that. Not only can the dream world bleed into the natural realm, the dream world can bleed into the spiritual. Wow, that's heavy, Lord. It can bleed into the spiritual realm when you're sleeping in the spirit realm. Woo-hoo. Wow. 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 Romans 13. Let's go. We got to be quick. Romans 13. Check it out. Verse 11. And that knowing the time that now it is high time to awake out of sleep, for now is our salvation nearer than we have believed, than when we believed. The night is far spent and the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. My God. Now you know why the Bible says, I believe Peter, that the day star shall arise in our hearts. The light is a representation of saying, wake up. When the sun rises, you ain't supposed to be sleeping all in throughout the day. Wake up. And there were seasons where I got into a vicious cycle of staying up very late and happened to sleep during the day. It was a vicious cycle. You got to break. But anyways, so those are some scriptures about waking up, right? The last part we're going to go to is about rest. God will give you rest. And not only that, but not to be afraid of the terrors of night. Because you're under the shadow of the Almighty. Under his wings does he cover you. Amen. Didn't Jesus said, oh Israel, if you would only come to me, I would cover you like a hen does with her wings. She covers her chickens, right? So anyways, y'all, I just want to take a minute and just be still to make sure I'm not missing anything. Let me just double check. Okay, I had other names of different spirits that attack in the night hour. But again, I'm not really trying to go that route. So, I'm going to keep it real with y'all. We had a good meal here. There's so much, but we got to focus in now on the prayer. Okay, and I'm going to break this prayer down into segments. One, I want to do a special prayer if you have children, especially newborn babies. I'm going to protect that precious child from SIDS, from that demon that creeps in from another dimension. Notice how that gremlin came out of the wall? It ain't that he lives in the wall. It's a dimension he came in. Stephen King is a warlock. When he makes movies, okay, he knows what he's talking about. Because he's a witch. He's a warlock. Okay, so I'm going to do that prayer. I'm going to pray that God will open up and germinate your gifts and grow them so you can actually operate in the gifts that God has given you. We're going to pray the protection prayer to protect you from filthy dreams, from incubus, succubus, and old hag, and the nightmare, and the spirit of fear. These beings that come in the night hour. Okay? Don't forget what I was telling you, how if you start noticing that the dream world is warring against you through that, hold on, Satan, because the dream world is neutral. Don't forget that. The spirit world is neutral. The natural world is neutral. It operates as a base. God can come in or the enemy. So the same thing with the dream world. The dream world itself is not demonic, but Satan can operate through the dream world. Does that make that? You understand? So we're going to pray that God can seal up the door that the enemy can use to corrupt your dreams. Sometimes God will give you a dream and a warning. Oh, here it is. Some of y'all oversleep. Let's go over a couple of things too. Get your pen and your pad. Write these down. One is, you need between 6 to 7 hours of sleep. If you oversleep, you can corrupt the message God is trying to warn you. Or you can sleep so long, you'll wake up drowsy, where you feel just, because you slept too much, okay? Some of y'all don't sleep enough. That's another issue. But 6 hours, 7 hours is really all you need, okay? But it's like when you over-season your stew, it becomes too salty and just the seasoning, you can't taste the meat, the potatoes, the carrot, you can't taste nothing. If you oversleep, it'll mess up everything that God was trying to warn you, and the dreams will kind of blend with each other. Have you ever had multiple dreams and they all kind of merge and you're like, oh shoot, what was God telling me? I've had some amazing dreams. Some of the most amazing dreams are when you're flying. Oh, I love those dreams. It's been a long time since I had one of those dreams. I've had dreams that were prophetic that I know is going to be in the future. I had a dream that the power of God manifested all in my being. And I went like this. And I raised up in the air. And when I spoke, it was the sound of many thunders uttering, thus says what the Lord said. And it was so amazing. I've had dreams. Oh, man. And Lioness could tell you a lot of dreams she had. So, with that being said, I'm all excited here just telling you about certain dreams. You ever have such an amazing dream and then you wake up and you're mad? You try to go back to bed. You're like, no. I've had those too. You know what I'm saying? I had a dream one time that I was eating a giant marshmallow. And when I woke up, my pillow was gone. Nah, I'm just kidding. Sorry, corny joke. My apologies. It ain't the time for that. But anyways, here it is. So we're recapping about this whole dream world, the spirit of slumber, right? We also talked about how the witches and the warlocks have figured out how to tap into the dream world and operate through the dream world to make us sleepy in the physical realm, right? You've seen the animals falling and dropping, okay? So, isn't there a movie-making company called DreamWorks, too? Because, you know, the television literally puts you in a sleep state. Do you know that? Where your subconscious is just like... So, this whole sorcery thing is to keep us asleep, but God says, wake up! Wake up! Oh, wait, before we pray, I want to read these scriptures to you. And write these down, and I want you to stand on these promises. Number one is Psalms 91. Okay, write that down. Now, Psalms chapter 3. We're going to be quick because we got to get this prayer in. So Psalms 3. You there? I'm there. Hold on. I'm there in 2 seconds. Bam. All right. So Psalms 3 verse 5. What does it say? I laid me down and slept. I awoke, for the Lord sustained me. That's a promise. I want you to write that down. Psalms 23. Thou lay me beside the still waters and restores my soul. You will sleep well. The still waters, the watering of the word. Amen. Psalms chapter 4. Check this one out. Verse 8. I will both lay me down in peace and sleep. For thou, Lord, only makest me to dwell in safety. That's a promise. You need to declare and believe that that is for you. Amen. Matthew chapter 11. Come on, we got to be quick here. Matthew 11. All right. Bam, I'm there. Matthew 11, look what it says. Verse 28 going down. Come on to me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. You see that? Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart. You shall find rest unto your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. For some of y'all that have trouble sleeping at night, for whatever case, these are the scriptures you need to... You need to learn to bring these scriptures to the Lord and say, Lord, by faith, you promised and I am receiving that you said you would give me rest. I don't need sleeping pills. And some of y'all, you might struggle with a little bit of withdrawals when you get off these medications. You're going to have to pray and fast your way off of these medications that have learned to imbalance the chemicals in your brain. I mean, look at what some of these prescriptions say. They tell you it can cause nightmares and hallucinations and fear. Think about that now. If the enemy can do that with that, who knows what they're putting in our foods to corrupt our dreams? We're getting nightmares. There's certain foods you shouldn't eat before bed. A lot of times they say dairy or spicy food. My recommendation is 3 hours before you go to bed, don't eat nothing or drink anything but like water. Okay? Don't get on electronics 2 to 3 hours prior to bed. At least 2 to 3 hours prior to bed, don't touch any electronics. So that way your brain, because when you're staring at a lighted box, your brain is vibrating. It's a time for your brain to be still. Remember, the rock was what Jacob rested on when he seen the vision. Rest on the word of God, and I'm telling you, your dream world will open up. And send us some emails when you get victory. Amen. So, that's a beautiful one. So, this is a good one. Matthew chapter 8, 24. When Jesus was sleeping on the ship, even though there was a storm, he slept through it. Jesus can give you that same blessing where you will sleep through a storm. I don't care if there's stress going on in your life, you have to learn to sleep through the storm. You need sleep to get strength. You got to charge your battery on your phone to work it, right? Same thing. When you sleep, you're charging your battery. It's a great mystery, I'm telling you. Two of them, Proverbs chapter 3. I just want to read this real quick to you. Because this one also talks about not being afraid. This is verse 24. When you lie down, you shall not be afraid. Yes, you shall lie down and your sleep shall be sweet. This is beautiful because it brings both in. Don't be afraid in the night when you hear things because you rebuke it. You do this prayer. You shouldn't hear things anymore. If you do, God is trying to show you something. Or sometimes it's the Lord. Don't get them confused. There was one night, and it happened to my wife recently, same exact scenario. There was a night when we were up north. I heard there was a noise. But it was different. It was a godly fear. It wasn't like, oh, a demon or a fallen angel. And when I went downstairs, I just got into worship. And I was worshiping God. It's like he woke me up. It's like probably 4 in the morning. And as I was singing, I was praising. I kid you not. And it just happened to Lioness not too long ago. A literal wing. I could feel it. It was like right by me. And I felt the wind of the wing of the angel. I was like, whoa. You could talk now and act like it ain't nothing, like you wouldn't be afraid, but that was no joke. I dropped to my knees and started worshiping God even more. So sometimes those noises is God. But anyways, my point is, rely on the scripture. Don't be afraid. Even Jesus said in John chapter 14, verse 27, to not be afraid. Amen. So, this is a lot. We got to get into the prayer. We could have kept going. There's other scriptures about dreams and so much we could have tapped into. But I think that's enough. I don't want to overfeed y'all. This is a very interesting subject that nobody really taps into. I don't, you know, non-Christians talk about this stuff, but not like this. You need someone in your life that will teach you the word of God and balance it and talk about subjects, but always bring Christ as the base. And I'm just honored that I'm able to do that for you right now with this word. Amen. In Jesus' name. So now, y'all ready for the prayer? This is it. This is what I've been waiting for. Hallelujah. All right. So, first one is for the children. Okay? You want to say this. Lord Jesus Christ, forgive me and my family for all of our sins and wash us and protect us in your holy blood. Lord, I pray right now over my child or children that you protect them, God, from the demons of the night, from the sudden infant death syndrome curse. Hallelujah. That you will surround them with holy angels protecting them in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, as you're doing that prayer, now I'm just teaching you the prayer. It's not like I'm praying it right now, because we already did the prayer with our children earlier. But this is our prayer every night. Lord, forgive us for our sins, known and unknown. Wash us in your blood. Lord, thank you for another day. Lord, protect us as we sleep. Keep your holy angels here with fiery swords, keeping evil out. If you should return as we sleep, take us with you. May we wake up and serve you and have a blessed, safe, prosperous day. Now, that's one prayer that we do. But you also have to, as you're growing and developing and you're living righteous, you won't have to be so like detailed with your prayer. But as you're growing, because some of y'all are struggling with incubus, succubus, you want to pray against whatever you're being attacked with. So you would simply say, after you did that simple prayer I just showed you, you would say, Lord, with your holy fire, put a wall of fire and protect us physically, spiritually, and in the dream realm, Lord, that the demons of slumber, the nightmare demons, the old hag spirit, incubus and succubus, and every demon of the night, every demon of fear, and all the demons of the dream realm, all these principalities and fallen angels, Lord, stop them from coming into our home, in the physical, in the spiritual, and in the dream dimension. Lord Jesus Christ, I rebuke these things. I rain down fire and brimstone on them. Lord, I repent of my sins. I repent for filthy dreams. Clean me, God, and may I dream righteous and holy. In Jesus' name. That's the other prayer you do. Now, if you are a partner, you should have received the holy oil, the anointing oil that we sent you with the package. Okay? If you're a partner, you should have got that. Anoint your bed. Anoint your children when they go to bed in the name of Jesus. Start to take authority. Learn to walk your house at night when people are sleeping and declare the victory. Anoint your windows and doors with the anointing oil that we sent you. It's anointed in the name of Jesus. The same way Paul laid his hands on the cloths and he sent the cloths out. That's what we did with that. Amen. So, the other prayer is that, Lord, cleanse me of all corruption, all chemicals. And if you're hooked on medications, whether it's sleep medication for bipolar, there's so many different medications. Lord, break the power of the sorcery in this medication. Lord, I'm going to trust you and not this medication that supposedly helps me sleep or helps me with ADHD or bipolar. I command the addiction to leave. Lord, help me to renounce this and get rid of it. I do not need this medication. Lord, heal my brain from the chemical imbalance and all the attacks and the chemical warfare they do, God. Lord, I don't want medication. I'm going to make a willful choice to get rid of this and trust you. Help me, God, and purify my body and my mind, my soul and my spirit from all the corruption and pollution of the enemy. Heal me, Jesus, so I can see dreams and visions clear without any interference, that I can interpret, that I can do your will and heed your warnings and receive your instructions when I lay down, like you said in the book of Job, chapter 33. I want you to visit me in my dreams, oh Jesus. Amen. So I know I'm doing it fast. Just rewind and write them down. Now listen. Then you're going to ask God to activate the gifts. Say, Lord Jesus, forgive me for my sins. I want you to use me as a tool. Give me the fruit of the Holy Spirit and anoint me with your gifts. I want to have dreams, Lord. I want to have visions. I want to be able to interpret. And Lord Jesus Christ, whatever gifts you want to germinate in me, to grow in me, so be it. But Lord, I ask for it now, that if you give me dreams and visions, I will be obedient. That when you give me a warning, I will take heed to it. Or I will warn the person you tell me to warn. Or I will do what you tell me to do. In the name of Jesus Christ, I activate through faith the gifts of dreams and visions and prophecy and interpretation and even tongues. Whatever is in me, through the power of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus, by faith, I activate these gifts to now work and operate through me by the power of Jesus Christ. Amen. That's amazing. So you're going to shut the doors in the dream realm. Say, Lord Jesus, shut the doors in the dream world that the enemy cannot come into my dreams and corrupt them no more. Hallelujah. Lord, I ask you to speak to me in my dreams. Show me visions even when I'm awake, God. Wake me up from the spirit of slumber. Oh, here it is. Also pray this. Lord Jesus Christ, protect me from the powers of witchcraft and the spirits that have me drowsy and tired and sleepy when I go to read or pray or do your will. I break that curse in Jesus Christ's name. Whew. Here's another one. For y'all that can't sleep at night and is messing with you during the day, say, I break the curse of the night owl. I break the curse of insomnia. I will trust the Lord. And I break these curses in the name of Jesus Christ, yes. And I will trust the Lord to give me rest. In Jesus' name. And a lot of y'all need to do this prayer. Lord, give me your sleep schedule and not mine. Ooh, that's good. Say, Lord, break a bad sleeping habit. Break cat naps. I break the curse of the cat nap in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, give me your sleep schedule and not mine. David said, I will rise up early and seek your face. Help me to get a proper sleep schedule. Not to oversleep, not to undersleep, and not to sleep when I'm not supposed to. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, I make you Lord of my dream world. I make you Lord of the spirit realm in my life. I make you Lord of the physical realm in my life. In the name of Yeshua Christ, I pray. Amen. I know that was like 8 different prayers, but trust me, that's so beautiful. I love this. This is amazing. And I know I'm gonna click off the camera and think of 20 other things I could have told y'all. We'll probably have to do a round 2 with this one, y'all. Get a notepad and start paying attention to your dreams. Stop eating trash, putting it in your body. It's not, I'm saying abstain from meats. I'm not talking about doctrines of devils. But you can't pray over Twinkies all day and expect it not to damage your brain. Fructose corn syrup and genetically modified foods and all of these things. The devil wants to corrupt your body and brain so the gifts cannot operate in you the proper way. Man, that's so good. It's like driving on the highway during the pouring rain, but the windshield wipers ain't working. You need the spirit realm, the physical realm, and the dream realm to be in unison, in one accord. May Jesus bless you with that for y'all that love the Lord. This is amazing. This is amazing. This is amazing. So you're going to pray that God will shield you and your family from the demons of the night, from the hag spirit, incubus, succubus, the nightmare, fear, tormenting spirits, the night terror. That's another one. And you just simply say, I put a hedge of thorn of protection, and Lord, put a hedge of thorn of protection around me and all my family and this home. And also, finally, from astral projection as well. Ask the Lord to set angels to protect your home from astral projectors. Amen. What a great meal. Amazing. God is so good. Wow, who would have ever thought? Huh? Let me say this too before I go. I've said this before. Jesus came to see me multiple times. And one that really stuck out with me was when he came to visit me in my dream. He was a janitor. He had on janitor suit. He had a ring of keys, tons of keys. He was brass color. His skin was the color of brass. And he was so amazing. I was just walking and talking with him, but I didn't know it was Jesus, but I felt my spirit knew it was him. But in the dream, I didn't know. All I knew was this is the greatest man I've ever talked with. I didn't want... You know what's so crazy is in the dream, I knew it was time to wake up. And I was like, wait, before I go, what's your name? And I looked on the name tag. It said Jesus. And I woke up. Now, I'm not going to tell y'all what we talked about. That's between me and him. But, man, get your dreams cleaned up. Eat better. Get off that medication stuff. You don't need sleeping pills and pills for ADHD. You need the Holy Ghost. He's your healer. Okay, start getting a right sleep schedule. Start learning how to pray better. We're gonna teach you how to pray better through Christ. Okay, if y'all need anything, you got any testimonies, just hit us up, leave some comments. And wow, what an amazing meal. Shout out to the King of Kings and the Chef of Chefs, Jesus Christ, once again, made such an amazing meal, and we just thank him. May God keep this word in us that the devil can't take it. Amen. And I want to pray for you. Lord, those that are yours, I want to pray that they sleep well and peaceful. In the name of Jesus Christ, I'm in agreement with them. Receive this prayer, brother and sister, whoever you are. I pray that, Lord, you protect their children as they sleep, that they sleep in peace with no fear. I pray, God, that you protect the children from the SIDS curse, from incubus, succubus, protect the family from the old hag spirit, the demons of the night, from Lilith, from night terrors. Hallelujah. Protect them, God, from astral projectors. Place a wall of fire around my beloved brothers and sisters that are in you, God. Shield them from the powers of darkness. May they sleep nice and peaceful. Break addictions of pills and staying up late, staring at their iPhones right before bed and not resting on the rock, which is Christ and his word. God, change their habits. Help them not to eat and drink certain things right before bed that can affect them in the mind. Lord Jesus Christ, activate the gifts in them of dreams, visions, interpretation of dreams, prophesying, tongues, interpretation of tongues, and wisdom. Activate the gifts in them in Jesus Christ's name. If you receive it, say amen. I speak it right now into life in the name of Jesus Christ. That your mind will start cleaning up. No more filthy dreams. I put a hedge of thorn around you and your family in Jesus' name. No more incubus and succubus. No more hag spirits and nightmares and demons of the night. May a wall of fire surround you and your home. For you that love the Lord, I'm speaking to you in the name of Yeshua Christ. Oh, hallelujah. And may he protect you when you're out and about from witchcraft and those that try to put a sleeping spirit on you of slumber, causing you to sleep while you read your word and sleep while you go to pray. And you always feel drowsy and taking naps and it's bringing you into poverty. I break it in the name of Jesus Christ. May God protect you and us from these witchcraft workers trying to make us sleep all the time. When Jesus wants us to pray, like in Gethsemane, why are we sleeping? Awake thou that sleepest. And rise from the dead and Jesus Christ shall give thee light. Amen. All right, y'all. Big ups to the chef, Jesus Christ. For y'all that are partners, keep a lookout. We got to get the web people doing that special part on our website where you can log in and you'll be able to listen to intense spiritual warfare messages, audio as well, so you can download them. Partners only, though. If you're not a partner, make the commitment to pray for us, to support this ministry, because this is a war and you should not be on the sideline. Amen. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for the meal. We get your plate from you. And as always, don't forget to leave the waiter a tip.